So we have got an amazing episode there. This is going to blow your mind. We have got Alex from Mixed Reality in Power Apps today, and he's going to show you exactly how to set up models in Power Apps and show you how you can actually take technology and bring it into the real world.
Hello! Welcome back to Less Code, More Power. Today, I am brimming with excitement because it's the best episode ever. We are combining my two favorite things in the entire world, mixed reality and Power Apps. I am not even kidding. Am I, Sarah?
Nope. No. So, hey, everyone. So, I'm Sarah. We're joined with Alex today. So, we're going to tell you all about Alex, and we really want... Please introduce yourself and explain, you know, give the audience a little bit of an insight, Alex, in terms of, you know, your journey in Microsoft, because I definitely think it's super insightful and super inspiring. And then also some of your interests and really how you got into working with this amazing technology.
Right. So I'm Alex. I started at Microsoft a while ago, working as an intern on teams across Azure and SQL, where I kind of hopped around a little bit before I joined full-time as a employee on SQL security and metadata team. And I spent like the first few years of my career kind of working on that back end, low-level platform code. And that all changed in around 2016 when I tried out the HTC Vive and the Oculus Rift for the first time. And, you know, like my world was just like completely shattered and changed. And I knew that like, mixed reality and virtual reality, augmented reality, all had the potential to completely change the way that we do business and the way that we do entertainment as well.
Just to interrupt you there, that was, I just want to pull this out because I'm a planner. I love like planning stuff and, you know, kind of, I definitely believe in reassessing and, you know, rapid reassessment, but you just bought the HTC Vive on a whim, right? You never planned to, it was just kind of, I'm just going to go ahead and buy it. And that just completely changed everything for you, didn't it?
Yeah, it was kind of a spur of the moment decision. So the HTC, like, so the Oculus Rift had just sold out on like the first day, and I saw that the Vive was going on pre-order, and I was like, you know what, like, I love video games, I love like all virtual technology kind of stuff, I've never really gotten into VR. I bought it, and then like the day it arrived, I like put it on for the first time, just like, holy crap, like this is incredible. So I think like that magical moment, like it kind of just like completely changed the way that I viewed my life. And like within like a year or two, like I knew nothing about making 3D content. I was never really great at 3D math, and then just like I just like dove into it full force and like completely changed my life. Yeah.
That's pretty cool, right? Taking something that, you know, because you don't have to be this, you know, this amazing expert at something to get good at it. And Donna, you can speak to this as well with like all your fashion stuff, is the fact that you knew nothing about it. You chose that you want to, and then you can go ahead and learn it.
Yeah, it's just curiosity. Right. One thing Sarah and I have seen over and over is the people who do the best in tech are highly curious about things they have no clue about. And they just go for it. It's not like, oh, I'm curious, let me read an article. It's, I'm going to go buy a Vive and change my entire apartment to be virtual reality capable and move my walls so I can have a whole landscape to not crash into when I try out my new environment. That is awesome. Speaking of, Alex, tell us a little bit about this tiny detail you forgot to mention about cult theater.
In college, I actually co-founded and ran a cult movie club with my friends. And so we started out as a small club of three members. And in the first year, we grew to the fastest growing club at Virginia Tech with like 39 members. So we showed like all kinds of like so bad it's good movies. My favorite being Uninvited. So you might have heard of Snakes on a Plane, but you've probably never heard of Cat on a Boat.
No.
Which is kind of the plot of that movie. So there's a genetically modified cat who escapes from a research facility who has a penchant for murdering Wall Street investors. So it was a pretty interesting movie.
I need this in my life.
I don't know how you don't know about this, Sarah, that you don't have screenings at your house.
You're just going to see it. I'm going to do this. I'm going to make this club too. You've changed my life.
We're absolutely speechless. This does not happen ever. Okay. So while we recover, mixed reality. So we hear you've brought something to show us.
Yeah. So yeah, we can go ahead and hop into the demo. So let me just bring it up here. All right. So this is Greendale Cooling. It's a small sample app I made just to show how you can take a AC sales field scenario and kind of transform it with mixed reality. So it's going to look really similar to other power apps, but we've added some geospatial and mixed reality goodies to kind of make it really pop. So first thing we're going to do is hop over to the select an opportunity screen here. And you can see that we can kind of select from a map different sales opportunities that we might have. And it's like really seamless. You can also use the address input control that we've added to type in an address, and it'll automatically pick the closest sales opportunity to us. So we're going to go with William G at One Microsoft Way. And we're going to go over to the inventory screen, which is just going to look like a normal Power App gallery you've seen before. But we, if we go over to the actual product page, you'll notice that we have this little toggle in the corner for 2D, 3D mode. And when we toggle into 3D mode, we can actually view that product in three dimensions and kind of see it from all angles. And you can easily then from there hop into the mixed reality mode by clicking that other button that we've added in the bottom right corner here. And here you can kind of like place it in your space and see whether or not that AC is going to fit. And usually probably not the greatest idea to have a full industrial sized air conditioner in your room or in your house. I think like it's probably not going to fit for us. So we can use some of our other mixed reality tools to kind of hone in on the best product for this customer. So hopping out here, if we go, we can use the measure and MR button to actually filter by size and find what products are actually going to fit for us. So here you can just draw a shape on the ground. And then once you've drawn that shape, we'll use Power Automate to filter the results of that we get back from here to actually take that list and bring it down to only things that will fit in that bounding box that we just drew.
That's amazing.
That is so cool.
Yeah. And so you'll see that we actually only have four AC units that'll fit. So we can go ahead and hop over to that screen. We don't have a 3D model for this one, but that's okay because you can also just go ahead and place that image and you can get a pretty good idea of what that thing's going to look like here. Mm-hmm. And this works really well for things like shelving or just like anything that kind of has like a really 2D footprint and like interface with it. But it doesn't necessarily tell you like the dimensions and sizing of it. But, you know, for our case here, it's pretty good. But like I said, like that doesn't tell you everything about it. It doesn't tell you like how it's actually going to fit there. It doesn't tell the full story. So you can also just go ahead and place a wireframe of that using the same dimensions. And, you know, like that combined with the image control, like we're pretty confident that this air conditioner is going to fit here. So we can go ahead and take this as reference. And we're pretty confident now that this AC unit's going to fit for this customer in this place.
That is awesome.
Yeah. And then now it's like we can just go through adding the quote. We can attach some photos that we just took in mixed reality to that quote so that we have it there for the future. And then you can like send that off to CDS and email the customer with that information.
That's amazing. From a sales perspective, it's great.
And that's just taking like a really like a normal workflow that you'd see. And, you know, just like adding mixed reality to it to like kind of like get rid of those rough edges that might exist. Like you don't have to take out a measuring tape or do anything. You can do everything in the context of the application.
That is sweet. All right. How does a layperson like me or Sarah, how do we build this into our app?
So I have here is a version of the app with none of the mixed reality capabilities added to it yet.
Okay.
So I can just show like really quickly how we can kind of attach mixed reality to it and kind of transform this app. So let's start here on the actual products page. Mm-hmm. So when we're here, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go up to the mixed reality control or tab in the ribbon, and we're going to add the view and MR button. So the view and MR button is what actually drives the mixed reality view that we saw where you use either an image or 3D model. So if we come in and we add this button, we change the view to icon, which I like because it just makes it look really clean.
Yeah.
And then you can bind it to the model that's stored in CDS. Mm-hmm. So the first thing we want to do is we want to set this source property to this pre-configured data. So this line that I've just copied in here might look like gobbledygook at first, but it's actually quite simple. So we're saying, like, if we have a model for this product, display the model. Otherwise, display the image. And that's it. Like, now, like, it's already hooked up to show that image. And we can just bind it to set up the length, width, and height so that it matches the dimensions of our product.
Nice. That's pretty good. So it offers, so organizations don't have to have 3D models for everything to be able to use this functionality.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, like, I think, like, the reality is that as someone who came in as a beginner, I think, like, the reality is that 3D models and 3D content generation is really hard. And I think, like, one thing I really wanted to emphasize when I started working on mixed reality for Power Apps is sort of the idea that you don't have to have a wealth of 3D content coming in. You can kind of just come in with, like, very low, like, small things and, like, a small scenario that you think can be made better with mixed reality. And you can kind of, like, find the ways to generate that content and put it in there. And as you kind of get more and more involved with it, you're going to hopefully fall in love just like I did and just want to find any way you can to kind of keep that going. All right. And so the other thing we're doing is we saw was the wireframe. We have a different control here, the shape and MR button. Mm-hmm. And we're going to do the exact same thing that we did with the model, where we just set it up with the same width, height, and depth properties that we had set on the model as well. So now they're going to be kind of bound to the same data.
That's pretty good. So you're just using the selected product from the gallery in the previous screen, aren't you?
Yeah. Yeah, and you need to change the unit of measurement to inches because a 74-meter air conditioner is terrifying.
Yeah,
and so that's it. Like, now our product gallery page is actually all set up with mixed reality.
Yeah.
And coming back, the other thing we saw was the measurement filter. So to set that up, we have a different control, the measure and MR button. Mm-hmm. So we can just drop that in here and kind of bind it, place it so it looks nice. And we're going to want to set that up with to be a... So we have in the measure button, we have like various different modes. In this case, we use the volume mode, which allows you to just draw that cube that we drew on the ground. And then we're going to do something a little bit more advanced here. I had preset up a flow that kind of takes the output of that and generates the dimensions. All it really does is it takes the output of our measurement control and kind of walks the path of that volume you just drew and calculates out the bounding box. So what we do here is we take all of that and we run it through Power Automate, and then we pull out those dimensions and kind of use them as a filter that we have set up for this list. And then the same thing here, we also want to use inches because that's the unit we're working with. Okay. And now it's like completely set up. We've gone from having an app with no mixed reality to having one that uses mixed reality in two different ways in like 5 minutes. So I think it's a pretty cool that you can kind of do this thing that used to take like a team of experts in, I don't know, 5 minutes.
That is wonderful and so cool. So now you just hit play and you go down.
Yep.
Amazing. So do you mind quickly showing people how to turn on these mixed reality features at all? It's over in File Advanced.
Yep.
So right there.
So once the first thing you have to do is you have to set up the ability to toggle on experimental features, which is a tenant admin permission. So if you don't see, if you come into File Settings Advanced and you don't see this, you need to contact your IT administrator. Mm-hmm. But once, if this is here, if you scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see this new little field, Mixed Reality Features. Mm-hmm. Turning this on and off will enable both showing the Mixed Reality bar here in the ribbon, as well as in the tree view here. Mm-hmm. And both of these kind of give you access to the same controls.
Yep. So all of you who are asking, how do you turn on this MR thing? Admin Center, turn on ability to see experimental features, then come to experimental features, turn it on, and you're good. Like, have fun with it.
Yeah.
Try it. Send us feedback.
All right. So I have some homework I kind of want to give to all you viewers at home. And just really to get you engaged with, starting to get engaged with mixed reality content and 3D content in Power Apps. So the first thing I want you to do is go and find a GLB model. There's a lot of these available on the internet that you can use as well. We probably have some links to resources in the comments down below. And just add the view in 3D component that lets you view a 3D model in the context of the browser. And just start playing around with that and seeing it. Then add a view NMR button to your app and bind it to the same 3D model. And then I want you all to go and take that model and view it on your phone using the view NMR component and just start really engaging with 3D content. And hopefully you'll have that same magic moment I had. And it'll just start letting your imagination run wild and let us know kind of like what cool things that you think of and share it with us on the Power Apps idea forum.
There you go. So I'm just going to go ahead and say that's the best homework anyone's ever given on the show. Because yeah,
raising the bar a bit.
Yeah, you raised the bar completely, Alex. This was amazing. Thank you so much for being here and sharing, first, your journey, but second, something so actionable and real and so useful. I can imagine this being used in so many industries across the board. And dear friends out there, we are just starting with the mixed reality and Power Apps journey. We have no idea what your use cases are, only you know. So please do try out the tools that we have right now and give us a ton of feedback so we can co-create with you and make them what they need to be. Awesome. Till next time, I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
And our special guest today was Alex. Thank you so much for being here. See you next time. Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.